थोड़ा मेहनत कर लो ना, अभी तुमको पैसा नहीं डालना है, थोड़ा मेहनत इज फाइन। Hi, what's up, you guys? Welcome back to my channel. Welcome back to another video. For today's video, I am doing another one of the cheapest makeup on a particular app. I told you last time that I'm trying to make this a series. So today we are trying out the cheapest makeup on Purple. Last I did a video where I tried the cheapest clothes on Myntra. If you've not checked it out, then I'm going to link it here for you. Also in the description box, so check it out. I'm sure this type of video has been done by other YouTubers as well. So I'm going to link some of them for you in the description box. So if you enjoy this, you can go ahead and watch them as well. But I had a lot of fun filming this. You're going to find some super, like, you know, unrealistic hits in this video. Like, I went into this thinking that I'm not excited, but the video just turned itself around. Without wasting any further time, we can dive straight into this. But before that, please, if you're new here, then hit the subscribe button, join the Sara squad. This might be the cheapest makeup on Purple, but subscribing to my channel is absolutely free. Also, click the bell icon right next to it. Uska koi additional tax nahi lagta hai. And then let's dive straight into this. Okay, I'll be very honest with you. I was not very excited initially, but now that I see all the makeup in front of me, there are a lot of brands that I've never tried before. Okay, there's like NYB, Stick, Woki, and a lot of like Purple's home brands, which I've never really tried. So I'm excited to dive into this. First, I have cleansed my face. So my face is very squeaky clean. I've used my Dermaweave Hydra Cleanser for that. I was asked a lot of times that where should you get your hands on this? You can get it on Amazon. I always make sure to leave the link in the description box for you. Super nice, fragrance free, and also soap free. So it's very nice if you have sensitive skin. Next, I'm going to go in with moisturizer. I'm using my Nutriderm Vitamin E Moisturizing Lotion. Love this for an everyday or also as a pre-makeup base, which I'm going to do right now. My face is very, very bare at this point. Okay, now that our skin is really nicely prepped, we can dive into all of the cheap makeup that is gonna go on my face. Don't really remember what I ordered for primer, but I think it's this product. This is the NYB Skin Neutralizer. It's the Balanced Burrows pH Balancing Skin Neutralizer. Don't really know what a skin neutralizer is supposed to do. Is it a mix of skincare and makeup? So this is what it comes in. It's a spray bottle. It is supposed to keep the skin soft, easy to apply, absorbs quickly, helps in skin repair, acts as a protective barrier, and controls sebum production. Let me spray and see what it feels like. It smells really bad. What does it smell like? Like a bad, not alcohol-based sanitizer. It's not alcoholic. The smell is not alcoholic. It honestly smells like water. It has distilled water, glycerin, and glycol, and honestly smells exactly like water with some very sanitized sort of a fragrance to it. So it's kind of nasty actually, but I think this is what I have for prepping the skin up. So I'm really glad I used my Nutriderm moisturizer, so my skin is not coming in direct contact with this. Quite a fail, to be honest. You can pass on this product. This was priced at about 199. This is what they have for the cheapest primer, and it's not really a primer. I need something that is like pore minimizing or sticky, tacky, and this has absolutely done nothing for my face. It genuinely just felt like water. So the next product we have is foundation. For this, we have the Stay Quirky Liquid Foundation. It's enriched with vitamin E apparently, and it is the shade Beige Bomb, which is number 7. They had only 7 shades to select from. It's priced at about 165, so it was the cheapest foundation they have. To be very honest, I'm quite surprised that there were actually 7 shades, because I remember when I was choosing on Nykaa, the cheapest foundation had only like 3 shades. I think it was from Blue Heaven or something. It has a very good texture as well. It's like, I don't know about the coverage, how good the coverage is going to be. It looks pretty sheer. Honestly, when it comes to cheaper foundations, they are never inclusive. But this feels like nothing, bro. What is the coverage? What is the coverage? It's like a tinted moisturizer. Honestly, it feels like a tinted moisturizer. Dude, can you see any skin color change? This is not even sheer coverage. It is no coverage.
Oh my God. No! God!
Let me do this on my hand and see. Okay, if it's... It's like a... tinted moisturizer. It has the mildest tint to it. Let me see if using a brush makes any difference to it. Okay, not really. It's not really helping. So we have no foundation today then. Because this foundation, even if it's brown skin friendly and apparently comes in a lot of shades, has no pigment whatsoever, no coverage whatsoever. It's as good as not using one, because at this point it feels like I have nothing on my face, just a very moisturized face with no color or coverage to it. This is such a flop, dude. At least you should have given me some coverage. Just the slightest amount is what I was asking for. Even a sheer coverage would have done, but this covered nothing. So might as well not get a foundation than get this one and waste your money. So I found another base product I got from NY Bae. It says foundation and concealer. It's in the shade Almond, and this quite honestly looks a little promising. I don't know if I got it from the foundation category or the concealer, but I'm gonna try this out as my base, and this matches my skin really, really well. I just hope it has some coverage. This is priced at about 115 rupees and it has shades as well, so it's brown skin friendly and it's cheaper than the Stay Quirky one. So if it has color, I think it would be amazing. I'm just gonna load up because I really want coverage. You're not getting a lot of product in this, but I definitely think that it has some amount of coverage. In fact, a lot more than the Stay Quirky one. I'm gonna take my sponge and blend it in. Dude, this is good stuff. This is really, really good stuff. It's a little difficult to blend, I won't lie, but it is blending and it is definitely, definitely adding coverage. NY Bae, I think you have made up your game again after disappointing in the primer category. To be very honest, that did not claim to be a primer. It was claiming to be a skin neutralizer. So only in the cheapest category did it fall under primer. But you can definitely skip on that and get this foundation, because this foundation is quite beautiful for the money. For concealer, again, I went with NY Bae because it was the cheapest concealer, and we have two right here. I got two shades because I wanted to see what matches me. So I have the shade a Honey Pretzel, which is very, very yellow undertone, and then I have Caramel Pretzel, which is very pink undertone. So you know what, I feel Caramel Pretzel would be a lot better than Honey Pretzel, because this is super yellow. Like, can you see? Super, super yellow. This is at least a neutralizing tone. So let's see the coverage, and then this is a very nice color match. It's actually the color match I go for in concealers. Plus it comes with a nice doe foot applicator. So quite impressed with NY Bae actually. I think they're doing a fab job when it comes to affordable makeup. Let me know if you want me to try out like a full face of NY Bae. Although a lot of the stuff today is from NY Bae makeup. Okay, so this concealer is 195 rupees. You're getting a decent amount. I think it's a good price. For the cheapest concealer, it's really, I mean, let's see if it blends. Oh, it is beautiful, yeah. It's easy to blend also. Nice, nice, nice. I like this. I'm gonna take it on my eyes as well and prime my eyelids, because we do have eyeshadow. I'm dreading it, but we do have eyeshadow. It is very easy to blend. I think it's medium coverage, sheer to medium. Like, not at all full. I can definitely build it up. But I love the color match. I love the fact that in cheap makeup, you're getting a lot of colors and a selection of shades at purple. Because the same is not the case with a lot of cheap makeup companies. They're not inclusive in skin color. But with NY Bae and Stay Quirky and all, you are getting a lot of color options. So that's nice. Dude, the concealer is doing a fab job. Like, I highly recommend this, even if you're not going on a budget, because it's not creasing. And if you have dry under eyes, you will love this because it's very hydrating. Okay, for powder, it happened to be one of my favorites. That is the Bella Worst Compact Powder. This is in the shade Lustre Silk. It costs rupees, not mentioned on this outer packaging, but I will make sure to leave it on the screen for you. And it's a very nice compact powder, to be very honest. Even if you're not on a budget, you can definitely check it out. It's a very good powder to just keep in your purse and, you know, touch up your makeup on the go, and sets your makeup in place. So it really locks in. You saw the concealer had a lot of shine to it, so it definitely does mattify your skin, makes your makeup last long. Again, has a few shades to offer for you to select from, so that's nice. Okay, I just realized that we don't have a bronzer to work with. I forgot to order a bronzer on purple because they did not have it in their category of divisions. And I totally forgot. I'm so sorry. But we have a blush. We have the Blue Heaven Diamond Blush on. So let's try this one. I hope to like add dimension with blush and highlight. The poof of the blush is outside the blush, but I'm not really going to use this because it has no padding whatsoever. It's literally a sorry excuse of a poof. This is in the shade 502. It is Rs. 125. The cheapest blush that Purple had was this one. I got this shade right here. There was a plastic that just fell off. It's like a rusty, peachy sort of color. I know it's a little darker, but I don't know how well it's gonna pigment, right? So let's first just swatch it and see. Ooh, it's shimmery. It's very shimmery. Oh, I don't like that. I like matte blushes, yaar. It's literally almost like an eyeshadow. It's that shimmery. But it's quite pigmented and I like the peachy reflect. It's a peachy, rusty color. I like it. Let's go in with my blush brush and see how well it performs on my cheeks. Ooh, it's a nice color. I like it. Quite like the color. Don't really like the shine it's adding. I mean, with this, you don't even need to go in with a highlighter. If you're using it on a daily basis, you can just use the blush. It has a very strong talcum powder smell to it. Like, honestly, it smells like Pond's ka powder. But the color is very pretty, huh? Very, very pretty. I love this shade. 502 is a very nice color. They add a lot of colors to choose from. I personally chose this. It's not overly pigmented also, which I like because I don't like my blushes to be very, very pigmented. Ek swipe mein only you see a lot of product and you can't tone down the blush. So I like to build it up according to my personal preference. And today I'm really loading up because I don't have bronzer, so I might as well take this high up on my cheekbone and add a lot of dimension with this itself. Okay, so far so good. This one also gets a complete hit from my side. Next, for highlighter, I'm a little scared. I've got this from Ronzil. It's their brick highlight. This is in the shade 02. Don't have the price mentioned on this, so I'm gonna leave it on the screen for you. It says 350 at the back, but I don't think that was the price of it. Ooh, this is like this.
Oh my god.
What I'm worried about is the very, very strong olive undertone that it has to it, and I don't have an olive undertone, so I'm a little scared to use this. But let's see, we'll start with a little bit of product. Ooh, it is definitely very olivey, but also very golden, like very golden. You know what this reminds me of? Fenty Beauty's what is that first one she came out with, which was very, very hit and it was a total eye catcher? The golden, golden highlight Fenty came out with. I can't remember the name for the life of me. Trophy Wife, Trophy Wife. Yeah, Fenty Beauty Trophy Wife. This is what it reminds me a lot of, Trophy Wife. Not like I've ever tried it, but I've seen swatches and this is what it looks like. It's straight up yellow on the face. And I kind of like it. That's why I'm like going overboard with it. Looks unique actually. I like how my makeup is turning out. I'm surprised to be saying this, but I like it. Moving along, I don't think we are setting spray either. So we'll just move along, zoom in, and let's catch up with the eyes. So for eyeshadow, we have this. This is the Blue Heaven Eye Magic Instant Eyeshadow. I don't know what instant eyeshadow means because it's not going to apply itself.
Great.
But this is in the shade 605. So this is priced at about 125 rupees. It has four shades inside and you also get this very sorry excuse of an eyeshadow applicator. What are you supposed to do with this? God alone knows. Then there's a protectant and we have the four shades. Now, if I'm not mistaken, the cheapest one was the eyeshadow palette I tried in the cheapest makeup on Nykaa video, which I had liked from Blue Heaven. I will insert a photo for you here. It was pigmented, decently pigmented. Some eyeshadows were a hit and some were a miss in that. So I didn't want to try the same eyeshadow palette again, which is why I went for this. So you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna first take this pink color right here, pick it up on my brush and put it in my crease. They're all shimmery shades, by the way. None of them are mattes. And I also have like a metallic eyeshadow I got from NY Base. So we'll try this as well. My base makeup actually looks really good. Huh? I'm very surprised. Just putting this on the crease. It is a well pigmented shadow, not gonna lie. This is actually showing up. Huh? These eyeshadows are actually good. Yes! Yes! I'm always so pleasantly surprised with Blue Heaven makeup. Like, I go into it looking at it like, it's not gonna perform. Because the packaging is pretty unimpressive. Like, very blah. But then I think they put all their money into formulation and don't really care about packaging, which I honestly don't mind. Honestly don't mind. Like, once it performs well, who the F cares how it looks? Okay, I really like this. I'm not going to try two more shades from this. I'm going to go in with the next product. So this is the NYB Liquid Illuminator. It's in the shade Manhattan Fairy Lights. Now, I'm not sure if this is supposed to be an eyeshadow illuminator, like a liquid eyeshadow, or it's supposed to be a liquid highlighter. But I'm going to use it as eyeshadow since we are done with highlighter and we love the highlight we are using. Okay, let's try this. It's actually looking pretty promising and NYB is really performing well for me. So... Ooh, love the color. Okay, I have a very strong feeling that this is supposed to be liquid highlight and not liquid eyeshadow. But let me tell you something. This is not very shimmery. Like, it's not straight up like a Swiss Beauty liquid eyeshadow or a Stila Cosmetics liquid eyeshadow. It's pretty subtle. If it's supposed to be a face highlighter, then it's spot on. Like, it's very spot on with the shimmer. But then I wouldn't use such a orange face highlighter. I wouldn't really apply this as a highlighter because it would look very out of place and not really where it belongs. And as a like an eyeshadow, I mean, it's decent. It's not really killing it for me, neither is it making up the game. So I really think like you can pass on this product. If you want to get a good liquid eyeshadow on a budget, then I highly recommend the Swiss Beauty one because I love those and they're really, really good. This particular product is a very meh one, matlab doesn't deserve to be in your makeup kit types. Kind of ruined the eyeshadow for me actually. So I'm gonna go back in with my Blue Heaven because it was performing so well, and we can make up. We can go in with the green and really pop it on the lid to add like a little bit of depth and a different dimension to our look. See, looks so pretty. Looks, it just brightened up my eye, dude. Okay, this eyeshadow palette gets like 100 out of 100 for me. Okay, for eyeliner we have this one again by NYB, and this is priced at about ₹90 only. It's the big apple of my eye, Kohl. Now this came under eyeliner section, it didn't come under Kohl section. The Kohl we have is a different one, it's by VLCC. So let's try this on top of our lid, and then for our waterline we'll use the VLCC one. Okay, I'm gonna take this on the top of my lid. I don't want to do a smoky eye, so let's do a proper eyeliner. Ooh, it's very pigmented, huh? It's very nice, smooth. Okay, 10 on 10 for this Kohl. Super pigmented, very easy to glide on, and such a nice precise line I've gotten without any struggles whatsoever. Did not have to struggle with this Kohl, and it's a retractable pencil, so I love that. I don't really like sharpening my pencils. For $90, I totally recommend you get this. So for Kajal, really I had this. This is the VLCC Kajal and it's only ₹55. I've never used a Kajal so cheap. In fact, I think I was using like cheap Kajals when I was in school. You know, you should get those green ones in the Dibbi. I don't remember the brand. But Lotus ka tha kya wo? I don't remember the brand. Wo actual Kajal jo hota tha jo nazar ke liye lagate the, wo wala. But apart from that, I don't use cheap eye makeup because my eyes are very sensitive. But VLCC as a brand, I do trust them, and I know they are inexpensive. Love their skincare also quite often. This is one of those very old school Kajals. Now triangle dibbi mein aata hai. So it's pretty nostalgic. I'm just gonna use this on my waterline. I hope it doesn't burn my eyes. That's it. It is very pigmented, not gonna lie, but you know what happens with these kind of kajals? The more you use it, the more difficult it gets to use, because then you like, it gets shorter and shorter and you can't get very precise with it. So I recommend you get the NYB kajal over this. Like, ₹40 zyada hai, but I think it's more practical and more pigmented, definitely more pigmented. But this did not burn my eyes or anything. I'm pretty eye safe. Oh, for eyeliner, we have this by Blue Heaven. Oh, dude, how am I such a nuthole? This is the Blue Heaven Wok Free Eyeliner. This is for rupees. This is for $75. It's even cheaper than the NYB one. And it's a proper liquid eyeliner. Let's just swatch it here. It's not very opaque. It's pretty watery. It looks pretty eh. I'm glad I didn't use it actually. It would have spoiled my makeup look. Because look, it's very watery. And it's not very pigmented, see? So I think it's a pretty meh product. I was very excited to see that it came like this because their mascara also looks pretty similar. And if you remember, if you've seen my cheapest on Nykaa video, you would know that this is the mascara that was cheapest on Nykaa as well. It's the Blue Heaven Walk Free Waterproof Long Lasting Mascara. And it's rupees 125. And to be very honest, it's a very good mascara. It's not the best, but it's again not bad at all. If you're like having naturally good lashes, then you know it's a good one to try out. It does the job. It is like it lengthens. It doesn't volumize that much, but it definitely lengthens. And I love the brush in it because it coats every lash really, really well. I'm going to take the same pink color and add to my lower lash line because I'm not done with that. Okay, I honestly don't know what I was doing or how distracted I was when I was ordering all this makeup because I don't even have a brow product. And I could take the mascara and make a do just slightly. Okay, then for lipstick, we have the Blue Heaven Matte Lipstick. This is in the shade Aged Wine 308. It's only 85 rupees and this is what it looks like. It's a nice bullet. Let's try it on. Ooh, it's quite pigmented. It's actually a really nice color. I love colors like this, which are wine deep burgundies. I think they look so good on dusky skin. And this lipstick is too good. It's very well pigmented, color's good, and for 85 bucks, you can definitely get some nude shades, use them on a daily basis. Let me know if you want to see more swatches from this Blue Heaven Walk Free lipstick range, because it's a good formula. Alright, so this completes everything that we had to try on from the cheapest makeup on Purple. And to be quite honest with you, I really like how my makeup is looking. Look at the base makeup. I have not had such a good base with such cheap makeup products ever. Even if you compare the cheapest makeup on Nykaa, the base was looking horrendous. It was horrible. Because base products don't really have that much color variety options or good formulations. But I think the changing game on Purple was NYB makeup. Hashtag definitely not sponsored, but I really, really liked it. I was super impressed with the concealer. The under eyes look so beautiful and good. Then also this foundation concealer, the stick foundation definitely changed the game after the Stay Quirky one spoiled it for us. And another one of their hits is the Kohl. Definitely the Kohl is really, really pretty and very easy to glide on. Some other products also that were real game changers were the Blue Heaven lipstick, the Blue Heaven eyeshadows. Dude, just look at my eyeshadow, it's spot on. And also this highlight, it's so pretty and so blingy. Very, very pretty. Actually, I went into this scared, but it's actually a good quality highlighter. The pan is also nice and big and it's not that expensive. So these are my recommendations from everything that I tried in today's video. Apart from that, nothing really blew my socks away, but I definitely think it had a much better turnout than what I was expecting at the beginning of the video. Let me know in the comment section, what do you think of my makeup right now? Do you like it? Do you hate it? Also, let me know if you've tried any of this and if any of this is your cult favorite makeup product. So let me know in the comment section. I just realized I had another NYB lipstick to try out, but I think too much NYB ho raha tha, so I tried the Blue Heaven one. But ab ye hai mere haath mein, so let us swatch it because it looks like a nude color. I think I want to get one nude and one winey shade, but the wine looks really pretty. This nude is the number one, and I think it's a very pretty color. Very pretty. It's a classic nude shade. I will wear it in some other makeup video for sure and give you all a lip swatch. But that was it for today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, then don't forget to give it a big thumbs up. For today's video, the Sara Squad shout out goes to Nitya Choksi. Thank you so much for watching and supporting my channel. If you want to be a part of next video Sara Squad shout out, you know what to do. Hit the subscribe button, bell icon right next to it, and also leave a comment down below saying hashtag Sara Squad, and you get a chance to be a part of my next video Sara Squad shout out. I will see you guys very soon in another video. Bye guys, love you, take care. Mwah.